Montreal, you still rehearse, but you do this for years, and you have done this for years and years and years.
Sure. For an artist, it's very important to have a discipline, you know. Mm-hmm. No matter how many years you've been doing this, you need to perform every day, and rehearse every day, and it's very important for that for us.
Judah,
yeah.
Yes. In your own country, the people here are used or grown up with flamenco. Why do they still come to your show?
I think because it's something new.
New?
Yeah,
it's traditional flamenco?
Yeah, well, it's not traditional flamenco. You'll see it tonight. It's something that came out different. I don't want to say new because everything is done these days. Everything you want to do, somebody else has done it already. Mm-hmm. But something different, and it calls people's attention, you know, and people really, really enjoy it. It's a show that brings a purist the same way as it brings someone out from the street, you know, it's for everybody.
Josue, you're the youngest of the group.
Yes.
You're 26, almost 27.
Yes.
Do you play a special part in the group, in this group of seven?
Well, I think we all play special parts,
mm-hmm.
unique parts, each everyone. But we all make this company
mm-hmm.
with a little bit someone.
help your brother.
Oh, my brother, yeah.
Yeah, each one gives what he knows, and the best way he knows how to do it. So, as he was saying, everyone is special in this company, everyone makes it unique.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, it will be Los Vivancos.
Yes.
You're like a hand.
You're, excuse me?
You're like a hand.
Okay, a hand. Five fingers, okay. A hand with seven fingers.
Yeah. Okay.
Talk about Spanish gays living here in cities and in the country. Can gays do what they want on the streets?
Yeah. People here. You know, Spain is one of European countries mm-hmm. where gay people can marry, so everything is really natural here. People can do whatever they want.
Mm-hmm.
Even though people from outside think that Spanish is really macho, traditional, that's not true.
Mm-hmm.
That's a typical.
Okay.
Yeah, that was like 50 years ago, people might think that. Mm-hmm. Right now, people are like,
yeah. But you stem from a family with 39 daughters and sons, a very macho mini culture at the home. What would happen if the 40th son would tell your father that he was gay? Israel.
I think there's no problem at all.
No?
Absolutely. It's something normal.
Actually, to you guys in Utrecht or Holland, it might look traditional because of the bullfighters, flamenco, mm-hmm. macho, but we have lots of gay people in Spain.
Yes.
More than you think.
Oh.
But yeah, the show, we are all straight.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really, we really like to dance like machos, and
mm-hmm.
we really like to give that sensation to the audience.
Who promised me that we can touch you during the finale? That was Israel.
Was it me? Yes, in the finale we go to the audience,
mm-hmm.
we touch them, to the people.
Yeah.
So yes, in the end.
And can men touch you this September?
Sure, why not?
Okay.
2010
depends
almost.
What parts.
Depends what parts, okay.
Yes. Where?
Tell us which parts are restricted and which won't.
No.
Waist up.
Yeah.
Now, Judah, introduce me to the rest of your brothers. You're Christo.
Christo.
Yes.
The cool guy.
Your instrument is?
Saxophone.
Saxophone.
The saxophone.
Oh, wow. You can play the camera.
Here we have two of our brothers that they are actually giving an interview. Mm-hmm. So we're going to present them.
So we won't disturb them?
Yeah, let's call it.
Okay. Yep. Yep.
This is Joshua.
Joshua, I give you my left hand.
And this, oh,
yes. Elise.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, just keep going with the interview. Thank you. And over there. Mm-hmm. He's the most hardworking of all.
Okay.
He's Aaron.
Okay. Aaron. Hi, Aaron.
How are you?
Aaron!
Hi!
It's now after the show. How do you feel?
I actually feel very alive, still with all the adrenaline in my body and ready for another one, I could say.
Tell me about that really remarkable family of yours. You have 38 brothers and sisters.
Yes.
How is that possible? How can one father have 39 kids?
You know, if I knew, maybe I would do the same. But I can't really explain how he did it. I mean, you see, it must be something unique, something special. Our father was a very man who was, I could say, ahead of our times. Mm-hmm. He was very special. Uh-huh. He had some attraction. He was really with knowledge and stuff. He was very, very good man with a lot of love and stuff. And I don't know, he was a machine, you know?
Know about the show, and it's a beautiful show, but on the other side, you make me feel lousy at the end of the show. Is that your intention, to make us feel lousy about ourselves and our bodies?
Not at all. No, not at all. I mean, it's you know, in art, in ballet, in flamenco, what we do is we work with our bodies.
But you make faces to us as if you say, eat your heart out, you guys.
Actually,
especially Israel.
Well, he's very, you know, he's
got, he's very handsome. Yes.
Yeah, great physique and stuff, but. You know, those faces, they just come out of our... So it's an expression. We don't actually think of it. They just come out, you're like dancing. So it's the emotion.
One out of seven men, statistically, is gay. You are with seven brothers. Give me the cell phone number of the one brother that is gay.
I think you... If there was one, I would give it to you, definitely. But I guess the proof is wrong. You know, the statistics are wrong. The bankers, I mean, we are all.
I believe you. We can only hope, Aaron.
Yeah, you never know. You know, things could change.
You're so young. I'll give you 20 seconds to tell our readers why they have to go to your show this 2nd September. Who wants to start? Josue, the youngest.
Well, if you go to the show, you're going to see seven machos, so you don't have to waste that. Waste that. Next one.
Do that.
You're not going to regret it. I think that says it all.
Okay. And Israel?
I think it's a unique show. Mm-hmm. You must see it to believe it.
It's a show to enjoy, and it's a one-time life show. So it's...
Well, that was more than 20 seconds.
Okay.
It was a great show, and we're looking forward to see you back in September in Holland.
Well, thank you very much, and I really want to go there, and we'll give you everything. So.
Thanks, Aaron.
Thank
Bye.
You.
Bye.